Hello friends, welcome back to Pathology Tutorials. Today I'm going to talk about WHO classification of CNS tumors 2021, which is quite a recent update. This is the fifth edition of WHO classification of CNS tumors, and it is the sixth version of International Standard of Classification of Brain and Spinal Cord Tumors. Prior publications were done in the year 1979, 93, 2000, 2007 and 2016. Now coming to the classification according to this fifth edition, the tumors of CNS are classified as gliomas, which are further divided into adult type diffuse gliomas, pediatric type diffuse low grade gliomas, pediatric type diffuse high grade gliomas and circumscribed astrocytic gliomas. Then comes the glioneural and neuronal tumors. After that, the tumors are classified as ependymal tumors, choroid plexus tumors, embryonal tumors, which are divided into medulloblastoma and other CNS embryonal tumors. Then comes pineal tumors, cranial and paraspinal nerve tumors, meningiomas, mesenchymal non-meningothelial tumors, melanocytic tumors, hematolymphoid tumors, germ cell tumors, tumors of the cellular region, and metastasis to the CNS. Coming to the gliomas. Here in this slide, I have simplified the things for the better understanding of gliomas according to the fifth edition. In this edition, the gliomas are classified as diffuse gliomas or circumscribed gliomas. So, the diffuse gliomas are further divided into adult type gliomas and pediatric type gliomas. Adult type diffuse gliomas are further of three types: glioblastoma IDH wild type, oligodendroglioma IDH mutant, 1p19q codeletion, and astrocytoma IDH mutant type. We can remember the various types of adult type diffuse glioma by using the mnemonic GOA, G, O and A. Then coming to the pediatric type diffuse gliomas, they are further of two types: low grade gliomas and high grade pediatric diffuse glioma. Low-grade pediatric diffuse gliomas are of four types: diffuse astrocytoma, MIB or MIB L1 altered, diffuse low-grade glioma, MAP kinase pathway related, then polymorphous low-grade neuroepithelial tumor of the young, and angiocentric gliomas. Low-grade gliomas, they show diffuse growth in brain with overlapping and less specific histological features. Then coming to the high grade pediatric type diffuse gliomas, they are location specific. They are either diffuse midline gliomas, H3K27 altered, diffuse hemispheric gliomas, H3G34 mutant, infant type hemispheric gliomas, and diffuse pediatric type hemispheric glioma, H3 wild type and IDH wild type. The next is circumscribed astrocytic gliomas. They are of six types. First is SEGA, then high grade astrocytoma with pyloid features, then astroblastoma MN1 altered, pleomorphic xanthoastrocytoma, pilocytic astrocytoma, and choroid glioma. As we know, circumscribed astrocytomas, they have confined margins. So we can simply say, unlike the adult type, unlike the diffuse gliomas, they have confined margins and they have particular shape. So we can remember these tumors by using a mnemonic, particular shape. P for pilocytic astrocytoma, C for choroid glioma, S for SEGA, H for high grade astrocytoma with pyloid features, A for astroblastoma MN1 altered, and P for pleomorphic xanthoastrocytoma. Now this slide shows the new entities which are mentioned in this edition and the revised entities also. So the entities written in blue color are new entities, and those which are written with red color are revised entities. This entity naming diffuse midline glioma. Now I will tell you the changes done in the revised entities. This entity named as diffuse midline glioma H3K27 altered. Earlier the name of this entity was diffuse midline glioma H3K27 mutant. Now the term mutant is changed to altered because in many studies it was found that H3K27 mutation was not the only change which was responsible for diffuse midline gliomas. There are other changes also, for example EZHIP protein overexpression. EZHIP protein overexpression, which was responsible for these tumors. So the term mutant is changed to altered. Then comes the other revised entity, which is choroid glioma. Previously, this tumor was named as choroid glioma of third ventricle. So in this edition, we remove the site designation. Two important changes are done in this addition regarding the CNS grading. First, the Arabic numerals are employed, 1, 2, 3, etc. They are used for the grading. Second change is neoplasms are graded within the types rather than across different tumor types. And this addition has endorsed the use of term CNS WHO grade. In prior classification, if tumor is classified as anaplastic astrocytoma. It was automatically assigned as WHO grade 3. No option for grading anaplastic astrocytomas as grade 1, 2 or 4. And if anaplastic meningiomas, they were also WHO grade 3. Even though meningiomas and astrocytomas, they are biologically unrelated, grade 3 tumor in these different categories was expected to have similar survival time. Clinical course is different for both these tumors, so their grade was correlated to clinical behavior. For example, grade 1 tumors were curable if removed, and grade 4 tumors were highly malignant, which leads to death shortly. Now coming to the specific changes which were done in gliomas in this edition. There is division of glioma into adult and pediatric types primarily. Earlier, the common diffuse glioma of adult was divided into 15 entities because of different grading to different entities. But in this edition, there are only 3 types of diffuse adult type gliomas, as we have seen in the previous slides, which are glioblastoma IDH wild type, oligodendroglioma IDH wild type and 1p19q codeletion, and astrocytomas. This classification only because of the use of the terms NOS and NEC. Now what these terms are, I will explain in my upcoming slides. Other change which is done in this edition is subtypes like gliosarcoma and giant cell glioblastoma. They are not listed in the classification discussed in the chapter. In 2016, IDH mutant diffuse astrocytic tumors were classified into three types: diffuse astrocytoma, anaplastic astrocytomas, and glioblastomas. But in this fifth edition, all these tumors, they come under one term, that is astrocytoma IDH mutant, which can be graded from 2 to 4. That's how they are grading the neoplasms within the types. And the term glioblastoma is no longer used in the setting of pediatric type neoplasms. Then comes the IDH wild type diffuse astrocytic tumors in adults. The presence of one or more of three genetic parameters appears sufficient to assign the highest WHO grade. And these parameters are TERT promoter mutation, EGFR gene amplification, and gain of chromosome 7 and loss of chromosome 10. WHO CNS5 therefore incorporates these three genetic parameters as criteria for diagnosis of glioblastoma IDH wild type. Now, glioblastoma IDH wild type should be diagnosed in the setting of IDH wild type diffuse and astrocytic glioma in adults if there is microvascular proliferation or necrosis, or TERT promoter mutation, or EGFR gene amplification, or gain of chromosome 7, or loss of chromosome 10. Now, NOS and NEC. NOS is not otherwise specified, and NEC is not elsewhere classified. NOS. This term is used when diagnostic information, both histological or molecular, which are necessary to assign a specific WHO diagnosis, is not available in a particular lab. NEC. This term indicates that the necessary workup has been done, but results do not allow for WHO diagnosis. For example, there is a mismatch between clinical, histological, IHC, or genetic features. Here, we use the descriptive diagnosis. Both NOS and NEC are facilitated by use of layered integrated reports, which include histological diagnosis, CNS WHO grade, and molecular information is listed in that report. Then comes the ependymal tumors. Ependymal tumors are divided into five types depending on the histology, molecular parameters, and site. Ependymal tumors are supratentorial, posterior fossa, spinal ependymoma, subependymoma, and mixopapillary. Supratentorial ependymomas are ZFTA fusion positive and YAP fusion positive. Posterior fossa tumors are group PFA and group PFP, and spinal ependymomas are MYC and amplified. This slide shows the new entities which are written in blue colors. These all are new entities. Then comes the glioneural and neuronal tumors. They are classified as ganglioglioma, desmoplastic infantile ganglioglioma, diffuse infantile astrocytoma, ganglioneuronal tumors, which are either papillary type, rosette forming, myxoid, and diffuse leptomeningeal. All these types are pattern based. Then neurocytoma, which is either central or extraventricular. It is site specific. Then disembryoplastic neuroepithelial tumor. Then diffuse glioneural tumor with oligodendroglioma-like features and nuclear clusters. Multinodular and vacuolating neuronal tumors. And dysplastic cerebellar gangliocytoma. And cerebellar liponeurocytoma. Now this slide shows that the myxoid variant of ganglioneural tumor is a new entity in this new edition. And diffuse गैंग्लियोन्यूरल ट्यूमर विद ओलिगोडेंड्रोग्लायोमा लाइक फीचर्स एंड न्यूक्लियर क्लस्टर्स एंड मल्टी नोडुलर एंड वैक्यूलेटिंग न्यूरल ट्यूमर. दीज टू आर ऑल्सो न्यू एंटिटीज. देन कोरोइड प्लेक्सस ट्यूमर्स. These tumors, their classification remain unchanged in this edition, although these tumors are separated from the category of primary neuroepithelial tumors. These tumors are further of three types: choroid plexus papilloma, atypical choroid plexus papilloma, and choroid plexus carcinoma. Then comes the embryonal tumors. Embryonal tumors are divided into medulloblastoma and other embryonal tumors. Medulloblastoma are further divided into medulloblastomas which are molecularly defined and medulloblastomas which are histologically defined. Molecularly defined medulloblastomas include those with WNT activated pathways, medulloblastomas with sonic hedgehog activated and TP53 WT type, and medulloblastomas with SHH activated and TP53 mutant type, and medulloblastomas with non-WNT, non-SHH embryonal tumors. Then other embryonal tumors include atypical teratoid rhabdoid tumors, ATRT, cerebriform neuroepithelial tumor, embryonal tumor with multilayered rosettes, CNS neuroblastoma, FOXR2 activated, CNS tumor with B-core internal tandem duplication, CNS embryonal tumor. Then comes the pineal tumors. Pineal tumors include pineocytomas, pineal parenchymal tumor of intermediate differentiation, pineoblastomas, papillary tumor of the pineal region, desmoplastic myxoid tumor of the pineal region, SMARCB1 mutant. This entity is a new entity. Then comes the meningiomas. Meningioma is considered a single type in WHO-CNS-5 with its broad morphological spectrum reflected in 15 subtypes. Several molecular biomarkers are also associated with classification and grading of meningiomas, including SMARCE1, which is seen in clear cell type of meningiomas, BAP1, which is seen in rhabdoid and papillary subtype of meningiomas. Other molecular biomarkers seen in meningiomas are KLF4, TREF7, TERT promoter mutation, CDKN2AB, homozygous deletion, etc. So that's all about the classification of CNS tumors, recent update 2021. Thank you.